India and Pakistan share a border almost 3,000 kilometers long, but there is only one formal crossing point. This is Wagha in Punjab. It should be open for trade between the two South Asian neighbors, but only a trickle of goods actually gets through. It's a symptom of the often hostile relationship between the two countries over the last 63 years.
We share common history, common language, culture, borders. So the upside is all but natural. The natural trade, if the political and other contentious issues or certain impediments are removed, it's going to increase in many folds, without a doubt.
There are many roadblocks to trade. New Delhi has imposed tariff and non-tariff barriers on Pakistani goods, while Islamabad allows the import of only 1,000 kinds of products from India. Meaning as much as 6 times official cross-border trade is either smuggled or expensively shipped via third-party countries like Dubai. Even in places like Wagha that fly the flag for business, regulations for the passage of goods seems to be almost designed to hamper efficient trading.
Wagha border is a logistics limitation. Right now we do have, like Wagha border, the trucks have to stop on one end. Physically they're offloaded by and then carried by coolies and then reloaded. So that's, I think it's ridiculous in our day and age to be having trade of this sort. Similarly, visas, businessmen visas, and that, you know, port of entry, port of exit has to be the same. You cannot have a businessman in a frame of mind to really grow business when there are so many limitations.
In economic terms, India has pulled far ahead of Pakistan in the last 20 years, with its economy growing at nearly 9%. Pakistan, on the other hand, regularly makes the list of failed states. Many Pakistanis can only watch the progress happening on the other side of the border without being able to replicate it. And for India, Pakistan represents a huge potential market for its products. At a recent meeting in New Delhi, businessmen from both sides discussed the possibility of collaborating in several sectors, including information technology, a sector set to quadruple its exports in the next decade.
India has really perfected the areas of business process outsourcing, the IT services and call centers and medical transcription and so on. So there's a lot that we can cooperate and we can learn with. The other important factor is India has great ambitions to the 2020 plan to grow from 50 billion to, let's say, 200 billion. And they have calculated they cannot do it themselves. So that is why they have set up outsourcing centers in Egypt, and probably they are setting up in Philippines. So why not Pakistan?
Despite fears in Islamabad that freer trade could flood Pakistan with Indian goods and stifle domestic industry, both sides have a lot to gain from working together, especially in the garment and textiles industry. These make up 60% of Pakistan's exports, and India too is facing tough competition from countries like China and Bangladesh.
They definitely can work together. And you see, supposing I get a very huge order for which I would need to increase my capacity. I have increased my capacity and tomorrow I don't have any buyer. So instead of my increasing my production capacity and tomorrow run after, you know, the markets and there may not be markets, I can look at India, and if I find some additional capacity available, we can make use of that. And by the same token, the Indian exporters can explore the possibility of doing it in Pakistan.
All this depends on whether peace talks take off between both sides. These were put on hold in 2008 after Pakistani-based gunmen attacked Mumbai, India's financial center, killing more than 160 people. India says it wants Pakistan to take action against the Islamist militants linked to the Mumbai killings before it discusses cross-border trade. But while the governments prevaricate, the business community is keen for action.
The business people can put the pressure. There has to be economic benefit from both sides. And if all these talks are derailed by the action of a few people, you know, then that is really sad. The two governments should solidify and not let these incidents derail the whole process. That is important. And India needs it. Pakistan needs it.
Despite both countries signing the South Asia Free Trade Agreement in 2006, intra-regional trade has not taken off. India and Pakistan are the two biggest economies of the area and could have created a win-win situation for the entire region. Instead, in South Asia, trade between neighboring countries stands at a paltry 3% of total trade, compared to 55% in the EU and 60% in NAFTA.
Canada exports 80% of all what it exports to USA, the next door. We are so unfortunate people that we haven't realized the potential of regional trade and what it means. It can bring peace.
Trade and stronger economic ties would not only help India and Pakistan alleviate poverty at home, but could well create a stake in peace between the two countries. However, the flip side is that unless there's an end to terrorism and an agreement on Kashmir, establishing better economic ties will remain an elusive dream.